Hi, in this video I am going to explain how to prepare bank reconciliation statement in four different situations. So let us see the four methods. First one, when balance as per cash book is favorable. In your problem, balance as per cash book will be given. They ask you to find out the balance as per passbook. The second situation is when balance as per passbook is favorable. So favorable passbook balance will be there and you need to find out the balance as per cash book. And third one, when overdraft as per cash book is given. Okay, overdraft means excess of payment over deposit. That is, excess of withdrawal over deposit is called overdraft. It is an unfavorable balance. So when overdraft as per cash book is given means you need to find out the balance as per passbook. The answer may be favorable or unfavorable according to the situation. The last one is when overdraft as per passbook is given. In your problem, unfavorable balance as per passbook will be there and you need to find out the balance as per cash book. In any situation, this is the simple format. When you start balance as per cash book, whether it is a favorable balance or unfavorable balance, when you start balance as per cash book, your final answer will be balance as per passbook. Before that, you need to add some item and you need to subtract some item according to the changes or according to the causes for the difference. So in bank reconciliation statement, this is a simple procedure. This is applicable to any type of method, whether it is a favorable position or unfavorable position, whether the cash book balance is given or passbook balance is given. So whatever may be the case, this is a simple form which is applicable to all type of method. If you start with cash balance, means the final answer will be passbook balance. When you start with passbook balance, your answer will be cash book balance. So in the previous video, I have explained what is the meaning of cash book and what is the meaning of passbook and what is the meaning of favorable balance and unfavorable balance, and I have explained the basic journal entries and I have explained all the basic concept about bank reconciliation statement. And not only that, I have explained how to prepare bank reconciliation statement when both cash book and passbook is given. Okay, in that situation, it's very easy to prepare bank reconciliation statement. Only thing you need to compare the cash book with passbook to find out the causes or differences, and then you can follow the same procedure. But in this four situation, you need not compare cash book or passbook. In your problem, they have listed out the various causes for the difference. So only thing you need to add some item and subtract some item to find out the balance as per cash book or passbook according to the situation. Let us see the problem first. So the first one, when balance as per cash book is favorable. So favorable cash balance means your deposit is more than withdrawal, means balance as per cash book is favorable. Let us see with an example problem. When balance as per cash book is favorable. In this problem, favorable cash book balance is given. They ask you to prepare bank reconciliation statement in order to find out the balance as per passbook. So from the following particulars of Mr. James, prepare a bank reconciliation statement as on March 31st, 2015. The balance as per cash book was 18,000 as on the same date. Okay, so the cash book balance, favorable balance is given. With this, you need to prepare bank reconciliation statement. Your final answer will be balance as per passbook. So these are the causes for the difference is given. Okay, you need not compare cash book and passbook. They have given the reason or causes for the difference. So why you couldn't get the equal balance in cash book as well as passbook? So these are the reasons. So now you need to start with balance as per cash book. See the answer. When balance as per cash book is favorable. Bank reconciliation statement of Mr. James as on 31st March 15. Start like this. Balance as per cash book. Favorable balance is given how much? 18,000. Now you need to add some items and you need to subtract some item. Your final answer will be balance as per passbook. So you need to find balance as per past verb. So before we see the answer, let me explain the basic some logic about how we are going to add item along with the cash book and what are the item you are going to subtract from the cash book on what basis. Some logic is need, no? Some logic should be there, no? So what is the logic? On what basis you are going to add and you are going to subtract some item? So for that I am going to explain a simple logic. When you start balance as per cash book, so you are going to start the problem with cash book balance, okay? So when you start with cash book, just concentrate the passbook balance. In this problem, various causes for the difference is given, no? So you need to add some item and you need to subtract some item in order to find out the balance as per passbook. Okay, for that you need to see the passbook. So each and every causes for the difference that will either increase the passbook balance or decrease the passbook balance. So when you start with cash book balance, you need to concentrate only passbook, whether the particular cause increase the passbook balance or decrease the passbook balance. One particular cause which increase the passbook balance means immediately you need to add the same amount along with the cash book. If any item which decrease the passbook balance means you need to subtract the same item from cash book. If any item which increase the passbook balance, that should be add along with the cash book. If any item which decrease the passbook balance means that item should subtract from the cash book. This is a simple logic. With this logic, you can prepare bank reconciliation statement in any situation, whether the cash book balance is favorable or unfavorable, whether the passbook balance is favorable or unfavorable. The simple logic is applicable to any kind of situation. Okay, so only thing is, when you start cash book balance, you have to concentrate only passbook. When you start with passbook means you have to concentrate only cash book. For example, if you start with passbook balance, okay, so according to this situation, you need not worry about the passbook. Just concentrate or look at only cash book. If any cause which increase the cash book balance means you need to add the same item along with the passbook. If any item which decrease the cash book balance means you need to subtract the same item from the passbook. If it is increase means add. If it decrease means just subtract. The same thing is just opposite. Your cash book is there and passbook is there, no? So when you start with cash book balance, you have to concentrate or look at only passbook. When you start with passbook balance, you have to concentrate only cash book. This is a simple logic. With this, you can able to solve any kind of problem. When balance as per cash book was 18,000, we have noted down the balance. So balance as per cash book, how much? 18,000 is there as on 31st March 15. So we are preparing BRS on 31st March 15, no? So you have to consider all the transaction as on 31st March 15. So the following checks were paid into bank on 25th March but credited to James account in the first week of April. See, you have received a check from Jonas 550, Joshua 850 and Imran 300 rupees. The three checks were deposited into bank. So when you deposit the check on 25th March, immediately you will make entry in your cash book, okay, which lead to increase your cash balance. But credited to James account in the first week of April. So till 31st March 2015, the three checks were not credited in your account. So what is the impact? The particular transactions recorded in your cash book, which is not recorded in the passbook till 31st March 2015. Okay, this will lead to increase your cash balance. This will lead to decrease your passbook balance. Just see the logic. You have taken cash book as base. In the first case, you have started with the cash book balance. I told you, no, you have to concentrate only passbook. So the first transaction is recorded. The following checks were paid into bank. Paid into bank means deposited into bank. These three entries are recorded in your cash book, which increase your cash balance when compared to passbook. Passbook value will be lesser than the cash book, right? So your passbook value is lesser than the cash book. So which impact? So what is the impact here? Passbook balance is lesser than cash book. Now you need to subtract. If any item which increase the passbook, that should be add along with the cash book. If any item which shows lesser value than the cash book, means the passbook value will be lesser than the cash book. So you need to subtract the same item from cash book. So according to the first situation, the check is deposited into the bank, so the amount will be entered in your cash book deposit side, which were not recorded in the passbook side. Okay, so in this situation, the cash book will be higher than the passbook. So you have to concentrate only passbook, no? So passbook value is lesser than cash book, which means which shows lesser value than the cash book. So you have to subtract the same amount from cash book. So balance as per cash book you have taken. Now you have to subtract the particular item. Why? Because which shows lesser value in passbook, greater value in cash book. So you have to subtract from the cash book balance. Checks paid into bank but not credited in the passbook. That is till 31st March 2015, the three checks we have deposited into the bank, but the same thing is not credited in the passbook. Jonas 550, Joshua 850, Imran 300. Total how much? 1700. Then look at the next adjustment. The following checks were issued by the firm in March and were cashed in April. You have issued a check to few people. The checks were presented for payment in the month of April. So we are preparing BRS on 31st March 2015. No, till this particular date, Princy, Ashika and Nazima, they didn't present their check into the bank for payment. So what is the impact which increase the passbook balance or decrease the passbook balance? At the time of issuing check to these three people, immediately you enter the transaction in your withdrawal side, which lead to decrease, which shows a lesser value in your cash book. But the same thing is not presented in the bank, so that there will be no entry in your passbook. So your cash book balance will be lesser than the passbook balance. So look at the passbook. Your passbook value will be greater than the cash book because you have entered the transaction in your cash book withdrawal side, which lead to decrease your cash balance. But the same thing is not recorded in the passbook, which means your passbook will be higher than the cash book. Why? Because the transaction is not entered in the passbook, so which lead to show higher value than the cash book. So look at the passbook only. So the impact is higher value. Now you need to add the transaction. Add checks issued but not yet presented for payment. Princy 350, Ashika 450, Nazima 500, total 1300. Next transaction. A check for 300 rupees which was received from a customer was entered in the bank column of cash book in March, but the same was paid into the bank in April. Okay, so you are preparing BRS on 31st March 2015. So till on that particular date, the transaction, the check is not deposited into the bank, but the same was paid into the bank only on April, the next month. So far till 31st March, this entry is not recorded. The check is not deposited into the bank, but this will be entered in your cash book. So which indicates your cash book balance will be more than the passbook. So your passbook value is lesser than the cash book. So because of this reason, your passbook balance will be lesser than the cash book. So now you need to subtract the item. I told you, know same effect. If it increase means add. If it decrease means just subtract the value from cash book. Check received but not deposited into bank. That is till 31st March, they didn't deposit the check into the bank. How much? 300 rupees. Look at the next transaction. A check for 500 rupees was credited in the account and was not passed through the cash book. A customer directly deposited rupees 500 rupees worth check into the bank, which was directly credited into the bank account but was not passed through in the cash book. So after receiving the information from the bank only, you can able to know this information so that you can incorporate this information in your cash book. Till such time, there will be no entry in your cash book. So what is the impact? Because of this reason, your passbook balance will show higher value than the cash book. So because of this reason, your passbook value will be higher than the cash book. So what is the impact which increase the passbook? No. So you have to add. I told you, no, same effect. If it is increase means just add. Check credited to the account was not entered in cash book. How much? 500 rupees. Next, the passbook shows a credit of 200 rupees for interest. Bank allowed interest for the deposit. Okay, this will increase the passbook balance, and a debit of 100 rupees for bank charges. So the passbook shows a 200 rupees credit balance and 100 rupees debit balance. These two information is recorded in the passbook, but the same thing is not recorded in the cash book. Why? Because company, they didn't receive any information from the bank. So after getting the information only, they can able to add this item and subtract this item from the passbook. After receiving the information from the bank only, they can able to enter the two transaction in their cash book. Now see the first one. The passbook shows credit balance 200 rupees credited in your passbook, which means your passbook will be higher than the cash book. So when bank increase your deposit or when bank credit some interest to your account, the passbook balance will be higher than the cash book. So immediately you have to add the same amount in your cash book. Interest credited in your account. How much? 200 rupees. Next one. A debit of 100 rupees for bank charges. So banker charge some amount, 100 rupees charge as a bank charges. This will be entered under withdrawal side. Why? Because which decrease your bank balance, but the same thing is not recorded in your cash book. So what is the impact for this? When bank enter bank charges in your withdrawal side, which decrease your passbook balance when compared to cash book, because the same transaction, the withdrawal is not entered in the cash book. No. So the cash book balance will be higher than the passbook. So you have to concentrate only passbook. The passbook balance is lesser than the cash book. So you have to subtract this value. Subtract bank charges. How much? 100 rupees. All the transactions were recorded according to the logic I've explained, you know. See, if any item which increase your passbook balance, you need to add the item along with the cash book. If any item which show lesser value in your passbook, which decrease your passbook balance, you need to subtract the same amount from cash book. So according to this logic, we have done with the problem. Now find the answer. take the total of this, how much? 2000 rupees, no? So 18,000 balance as per cash book, add 2000 rupees, 20,000, and take this total 2100. 20,000 minus 2100, 17,900. Balance as per passbook also favorable. If you get negative value means, for example, your total deposit is 20,000 rupees, no? So the minus item means 22,000 means you will have 2,000 rupees negative value. Then the balance as per passbook will be OD, overdraft. But according to this problem, we have got plus value. Okay, favorable value. So this is called as balance as per passbook favorable balance. Look at the second situation. When balance as per passbook is favorable. So favorable balance means your passbook balance deposit side is more than the withdrawal side. Then it is called as a favorable balance as per passbook is given. With this information, they ask you to prepare bank reconciliation statement in order to find out the balance as per cash book. So from the following particular, ascertain the balance as per cash book of Mr. Tariq as of 31st March 2015. See? First one, credit balance as per passbook as on 31st March 2015, rupees 2500. Start with this. So when balance as per passbook is favorable, how much? 2500 favorable balance is there. Now you have to add some item and you have to subtract some item so that you will get balance as per cash book. Okay, so in order to find the balance as per cash book, you need to add some item and you need to subtract some item according to the simple logic I've explained, you know. According to this problem, in the second problem, we are going to start with passbook balance. Okay, so now you have to focus only cash book. Whether each and every cost will increase the cash book balance or decrease the cash book balance. According to that, we can add or subtract from passbook. So if you start with passbook, you have to concentrate only cash book. Look at the first one. Bank charges 100 rupees had not been entered in cash book. This information, bank will charge some amount for the service which is rendered by the bank to the customer, no? Okay, this amount will be entered in withdrawal side, which will lead to decrease your passbook balance. But the same thing is not entered in cash book. What is the impact for this? Your cash book balance will show higher than the passbook value. Okay, this information is not recorded in the cash book, no? So the impact is cash book balance will be higher than the passbook balance. Okay, so now you have to add along with passbook. Bank charges 100 rupees. Look at the next transaction. Out of the checks of 3500 paid into bank, a check of rupees 1500 was not yet credited by the banker. Okay, so you have deposited few checks worth 3500. Out of 3500, a check worth rupees 1500 was not yet credited by the banker. So what is the difference between these two? 3500 minus 1500, 2000 rupees credited in your bank. But 1500 is the difference. This amount is not credited in your bank passbook, but the same thing will be recorded in your cash book. In your cash book, deposit side 3500 will be there, but actually in your passbook entry only 2000 rupees credited. That will be recorded in the passbook deposit side. What is the difference? 1500 rupees was not yet credited by the bank, so your bank balance will be lesser than the cash balance, because in cash book 35 is there, but in passbook only 2000 rupees credited in your bank account. So the difference 1500. Because of this reason, your bank balance will be lesser than the cash book balance. So your cash book balance will be higher value. Because of this reason, cash book balance will be higher than the passbook. So you have to add along with the passbook. Right here, check deposited but not at creditor. 3,500 minus 2,000. So 2,000 rupees creditor, only 1,500 rupees not yet creditor. Just add 1,500. Next transaction. Out of the checks issued for 10,000 rupees, checks of 9,200 only were presented for payment. You have issued 10,000 rupees value of check to few people, to your supplier, but the supplier present out of payment only for 9,200. What is the difference between these two? 800 rupees value of check was not presented for payment. So the difference between these two is 800 rupees. But in your passbook, you have entered 10,000 rupees under withdrawal side. But in the passbook, actual withdrawal only 9,200. So 800 rupees is not recorded in the withdrawal side of passbook, which lead to show higher value in passbook, but the cashbook balance will be lesser than the passbook. So just look at the cashbook. So your cashbook balance will be lesser than the passbook. Why? Because in cash book you have entered 10,000 under withdrawal side, but the same amount is not recorded in the passbook. Only 9,200 entered in the withdrawal side. 800 rupees is difference is there, no? Which lead to decrease the cash book balance. So again you have to subtract the same value from the passbook. Minus check issued but not presented for payment. How much? 10,000 minus 9,200, 800 rupees. Next transaction. A dividend of rupees 900 was collected by the banker directly but not entered in the cash book. So as per the standing instruction, the banker can collect any income or banker can pay any payment as per the standing instruction which is given by the customer. A dividend of rupees 900 was collected by the bank directly. This will be entered in the passbook deposit side, which lead to increase your passbook balance, but the same transaction is not entered in the cash book. Why? Because company, they didn't receive any information from the bank. So after getting the information only, they can able to enter the transaction in the deposit side of cash book. So till such time, there will be no entry. Because of this, passbook balance will be greater than or higher than the cash book. So what is the impact on cash book? Cash book balance will be lesser than the passbook. So you have to focus only cash book, no? So cash book balance will be lesser than the passbook, no? So you have to subtract the same value from passbook. Dividend collected by the bank but not entered in the cash book. How much? 900 rupees. Look at the last transaction. A check of rupees 750 had been dishonored prior to 31st March, but no entry was made in the cash book. See, at the time of depositing the check into the bank, immediately you will enter in your cash book deposit side, which lead to increase your bank balance. Okay, but the same transaction will not be recorded by the banker. The banker will send the check to the core bank, the issuer bank, in order to collect the money. After collecting the money only, the banker will enter the amount in your passbook deposit side. But meanwhile, there will be no entry in the passbook. If the check is dishonored means the check is not converted into cash. Okay, because of some reason, insufficient fund or some reason, the check will not honored by the issuer bank. So in this situation, the check will be dishonored. So here, the banker will not make entry. So there will be no entry at the time of receiving, or in case of dishonor, there will be no entry in the passbook. But the same thing, the dishonor information is not recorded in the cash book. So what is the impact? Because of this reason, the 750 is entered in the deposit side. The dishonor information is not entered in the cash book. In passbook, there is no entry for dishonor. because the check is not accepted by the issuer bank. So because of this reason, your bank balance, that is passbook balance, will be lesser than the cashbook balance. So a cashbook balance will be higher because this information is not recorded. No, you assumed that this amount is increase your cash balance. So in your cashbook balance higher than the passbook. In passbook, that amount will not recorded. No, so there will be no increase in the passbook. In cashbook, it will be showing higher value than the passbook. So now you have to add. Dishonor of check not recorded in cashbook. 750. So all the transactions you have entered in the bank reconciliation statement. Now you have to take the total. Find the total. How much? 2350. Add along with the balance as per passbook. The total amount is 4850. Now take this total. 1700. Subtract from this value, your balance amount is 3150. So this is the balance as per cashbook. You started with balance as per passbook. No, the final answer will be balance as per cashbook. So according to this problem, you have got favorable balance. Plus value is there. No, so this is called as favorable balance. Look at the third situation. When overdraft as per cashbook is given. So I told you, no, what is the meaning of overdraft? Overdraft means excess of withdrawal over deposit is called overdraft. This is an unfavorable balance as per cashbook is given. So with this information, see the problem. Prepare a bank reconciliation statement as at June 30, 2015 for Mr. Ajay Private Limited from the information given below. Some information is given. With this information, they ask you to prepare bank reconciliation statement in order to find out the balance as per passbook. So cashbook balance is given, unfavorable balance is given. Now you need to start with this, and your final answer will be either favorable passbook balance or unfavorable passbook balance. So first you need to start with the opening balance. So bank overdraft as per cashbook 120,000. Overdraft as per cashbook, how much? 120,000. This is a negative value. Okay, so unfavorable value. No, now you need to add some item along with this balance, and you need to subtract some item from this value. The final balance will be 1,000. The answer may be favorable or unfavorable according to the changes or according to the situation. Look at the first situation. Checks issued on June 20th, 2015, but not yet presented for payment, 15,000. So 15,000 value of check you have issued to your supplier on 20th June, but the same thing was not presented for payment till 30th June. Okay, so check issued on June 20th, but not yet presented. Not yet means till 30th June the check was not presented for payment. So what is the impact? So this withdrawal will be recorded in your cash book, but the same thing will not be appeared in the passbook. So your cash book balance will be lesser than the passbook balance. See, you are starting with the cashbook, no? Cashbook balance, no? You have to concentrate only passbook. So this entry, the check issued but not yet presented for payment, no? So this entry will be recorded in your cashbook, which will decrease your cash balance, but the same thing is not recorded in the passbook. So what is the impact? What is the result? The passbook balance will be higher than the cashbook balance. So when you start with cashbook, you have to focus only passbook. So your passbook will be higher than the cashbook. No, just add. Checks issued but not yet presented for payment. How much? 15,000. Next transaction, checks deposited but not yet credited by bank. You have deposited 23,500 value of check into the bank. Immediately you will enter the transaction in your cash book deposit side, which lead to increase your cash balance. But the same thing is not recorded in the passbook. Your passbook balance is lesser than the cash book. So you have entered the transaction in your cash book, no? So your cash book value is more than the passbook. Your passbook will be less than the cash book. You have to focus only passbook. So passbook will be lesser than the cash book, no? So subtract that value from cash book. Checks deposited but not yet credited. How much? 23,500. Next transaction. Interest on investment directly collected by the bank, 45,000 rupees. It is an income, no? So when bank receive any income on behalf of the customer, so this will be recorded in deposit side. Why? Because which will increase your bank balance. So interest on investment directly collected by the bank and entered in the deposit side. So this information is not recorded in the cash book. After getting information from the banker only, we can able to make entry in our cash book. So till this information is not recorded in the cash book, but which is recorded in the passbook, which lead to increase passbook balance, and cash book balance will be lesser than the passbook. So you have to focus only passbook, no? So because of this reason, the passbook balance will be higher than the cash book. Now you have to add along with cash book. Interest on investment. How much? 45,000. Collected by the bank directly. Next one, interest on overdraft debited by bank. So what is the meaning of overdraft? Withdrawing excess amount than the deposit. So this facility is available to only current account holders. They can avail this facility from the banker, and for that they need to pay some interest on overdraft. So daily basis banker will calculate and charge interest on overdraft. This will lead to decrease your bank balance. So this amount is debited by the bank in the customer's account, which will lead to decrease the bank balance. But the same thing is not recorded in the cash book, no? So your cash book will be higher than the passbook. Your passbook is lesser than the cash book. Because of this, your passbook shows lesser value than the cash book. So now you have to subtract from cash book. Interest on overdraft. How much? 8,000 rupees. Last one, amount wrongly debited by bank. So this is also one of the possibility of showing different balance. Sometimes for some reason banker may do some mistakes, no? So amount wrongly debited by bank, 2000 rupees. So this will lead to decrease your passbook value. Okay, but the same thing is not entered in, the same wrong entry is not recorded in the cash book, no? So because of this reason, your cash book balance will be higher than the passbook value. Your passbook value will be lesser than the cash book value. So your passbook shows lesser value than the cash book because of wrong debit. Again, you have to subtract the same value from cash book. Wrong debit. How much? 2000 rupees. Now you have to find the total. See, the same procedure applicable whether you take a cash book balance favorable or unfavorable, or your base value is passbook balance favorable or unfavorable. The logic will be remained same. There will be no difference at all. Now take the total. 60,000, no? Just put 60,000 here. What you are supposed to do, you need to add, no? But already you have negative value. You are supposed to add 60,000, no? So minus plus minus. Okay, so which amount is higher value? 120 is higher, no? You have to put the same symbol, minus. Okay, minus plus minus, no? 120 minus 60, 60,000. Again, the value is minus 60,000 is there. Now you have to subtract these value. So what is the total? Just take the total, 33,500. 500. You are supposed to subtract this amount from this value, but already we have got minus value. Minus into minus is equal to plus. No, you have to add two minus, but you have to write minus symbol because both are minus value. No, so minus into minus plus. So just add the two value, 93,500. Your final answer is negative value. No, so this is called as a overdraft, unfavorable balance. So balance as per passbook is unfavorable, that is overdraft. You started with overdraft as per cashbook. No, 1,20,000. Your final answer is balance as per passbook, that is overdraft as per passbook, 93,500. You may get sometimes favorable balance also. So according to the situation, you may get either favorable or unfavorable. Look at this problem. When overdraft as per passbook is given, okay, so with this information you need to prepare bank reconciliation statement in order to find out the balance as per cashbook. See, Miss Grace gives you the following information regarding her bank account. It shows on overdraft balance of rupees 12,000 on 31st March 2015. This does not agree with the cashbook balance. So you need to find out the cashbook balance. Check amounting to rupees 20,000 were paid into bank, out of which only checks amounting to 10,000 were credited by the bank. In this problem, overdraft as per passbook is given 12,000. So overdraft means unfavorable balance as per passbook. No, so put negative value. It is an unfavorable balance. So minus 12,000. Again, you have to add some item and subtract some item. Your final answer will be balance as per cashbook. This may be favorable or unfavorable. Look at the first adjustment. Checks amounting to rupees 20,000 were paid into bank, out of which only checks amounting to 10,000 were credited by the bank. So you have entered 20,000 in your cash book, but actually 10,000 rupees value of check is collected by the bank or credited by the bank. The remaining 10,000 rupees not yet credited. So what is the impact? Your cash balance will be more than or higher than the passbook balance. So your cash book will be higher than the passbook balance. So now you need to, so you started with the passbook. No, we started with passbook. You need to concentrate only cashbook. So because of this reason, your cashbook balance is more than the passbook. You need to add the difference. The 10,000 rupees should be added along with the passbook. Check deposited but not yet collected by the bank. So 20,000, no, only 10,000 rupees credited. The remaining 10,000 is not yet credited by the bank. Next, checks issued during March amounted in all to 10,000 rupees. Out of these, checks amounting to rupees 5,000 were unpaid till March 31st, 2015. You have issued 10,000 rupees value of check to few people, to your supplier. Out of 10,000 rupees, only 5,000 rupees checks were unpaid. The remaining 5,000 rupees is paid off. So because of this reason, your bank balance, that is you have entered 10,000 in your cash balance, no, but in your passbook only 5,000 rupees is deducted. The remaining 5,000 rupees is there in your bank balance. So because of this, your cash book will be lesser than the passbook. So you need to concentrate only cash book. No, so your cash book is lesser than the passbook. Now you need to subtract the difference from passbook. Checks issued but not presented for payment. How much? 10,000 minus 5,000. Balance 5,000 rupees. Next, a bank has wrongly debited account number 1 with 1,500 in respect of a check drawn on account number 2. Bank wrongly debited. They are going to subtract the amount. They need to enter this amount in account number 2, but they wrongly entered in your account. So the bank has wrongly debited account number 1 with 1,500 rupees. This is a wrong debit. No, this will lead to decrease your passbook value, but the same thing is not entered in the cash book, no? So a cash book will be higher than the passbook. So a cash book will be higher than the passbook. Now you need to add the amount along with the passbook. Wrong debit. How much? 1500. The account stands debit with 250 for interest and 100 rupees for bank charges. So in your passbook, 250 rupees debited and 100 rupees also debited in your passbook because of 250 interest charged by the bank and 100 rupees bank charges. The two information is not recorded in the cash book. So because of this reason, your cash book will be higher than the passbook value. So you have to look at only cash book, no? Your cash book value is higher than the passbook. Now you need to add along with the passbook. Interest debited, bank charges also debited. How much? 250, 100. Last one. The bank has paid the annual subscription of rupees 200 to club according to instruction. So according to the standing instruction, the bank has paid 200 rupees to club. This information is entered in the passbook, which will lead to decrease the passbook value, but the same thing is not recorded in the cash book, no? So cash book balance will be higher than the passbook. So now you need to add along with the passbook. Annual subscription debited. How much? 200. Now take the total. Total of this amount is 12,050. See, now you are supposed to add along with the opening value, but we have negative or unfavorable passbook balance, no? So minus into plus, minus. So which amount is higher value? This is higher value, no? You can put the same symbol. Okay, so 12,000 minus 50 rupees. You need to subtract this amount from this value, no? So you need to subtract, no? Just subtract 5,000 rupees. Okay, so already you have plus 50 and minus 5,000 rupees. So which value is higher value? 5,000 is higher, no? Put the same symbol here. So the balance is plus into minus, minus 4,950. Minus value is there, no? So minus value means unfavorable balance as per cash book, that is overdraft as per cash book. As per cash book, 4,950. Thank you.